Alright, sure, I'd like to go on the tour then.
Excellent! You won't regret it! My tours are one of a kind! Now, there's just the matter of price. The going rate for a genuine Starsap tour is only 100 credits!
Sure.
Great! Let's get this show on the road, eh? Alright, so, this is New Homestead's main concourse. This underground area didn't exist when the original outpost, titled Astro Base, was finished in 2130. Follow me. We'll come back here by the end of the tour and talk about the museum collection. But first...
I decided to take a tour of New Homestead with Bill Starsap so I can learn more about its history.
Go see where people live.
It's
now
one
remember,
thing to learn
these
about
people
early colony
actors.
Life.
They
it's another to
live
experience
here, so try to be respectful of that. While the original inhabitants of the Titan Astro Base lived in pods like you saw up above, they transitioned down here when this section of the base was finished in 2144.
I thought it was a show us around the museum.
Space is extremely limited, so you'll notice some overflow here. But more residences also exist on lower levels, which are inaccessible to tours. I'll stop at each of our destinations if you want to look
spaceship.
Around. Or if you
I
have any questions
I'm older.
For me.
They're so cool.
Kids talking when you're talking. You're just gonna hang out there? Because I'm gonna look around and maybe talk to this kid if everyone's back over here. Hey.
Ah! That's the torch energy! I wanna run around!
Oh my god. Alright. Possessed child. The good doctor? Not in. Anyone not following the rules will be denied access to the lab. Don't touch the animals, wear safety goggles, wear a lab coat, wear gloves when necessary, don't eat at your workstation, clean up your workspace. Know where safety equipment is located and how to use it. Eye watch station, safety shower, fire blanket, and emergency shutoff controls. Be aware of evacuation exits and fire extinguisher locations. Know where material safety data sheet, MSDS, information is kept and how to use the information. To alert you of hazards such as biohazards and corrosive materials, there are hazard signs placed in this laboratory. To help you be aware of the various meanings associated with these signs, refer to the Worker's Handbook under the section Safety Practices in the Lab. Synthameat Turkey. 3 health, that's not even worth it really. Superfood paste kit. Water packs. Coffee bags for crafting. Meal tray. Stick. But I can't. I'm trying to sneak and get it. Wait. That would stop that. Got our hand stuck in there. If you're coming in, come in. I'm trying to grab the cred stick without being seen or perceived in some way. 198. History of Xenobiology. Dark log. The first several chapters of Lars Nielsen's work seem to focus primarily on the digestive systems of alien herbivores. The dissection of Dr. Lord's latest find revealed a creature that was, just as she suspected, based on its outward appearance, an evolution of the microscopic hydrothermal worm. But her research also suggested a species that evolved in distinct stages, possibly growing significantly as it did. So the question now remains, which version of the creature did Dr. Lord dissect, and what maximum size could it possibly achieve? The subsequent passages deal with Nielsen's fascination with the predatory wildlife of some unnamed world. Pool ball. Oh, the one. It's the one ball. Those are fake books, I guess. Yeah, not real. Not real, man. It's not real. Okay. Alright, so you're gonna hang out there. I'm gonna take a look in here. I got some kind of living quarters. Clamp and vacuum tape. Small moonshine jug. Hi.
If you need medical attention, see Dr. Lakota. But a word of warning, she really doesn't care for tourists.
Is this supposed to be some kind of toilet? There's nothing under it, though. These people like their moonshine around here. Take a load off, why don't you?
Sure would be nice to get off world sometime.
Yeah, it's like they're giving them guilt trips over leaving. Which is not fair. Interesting how this is all set up. Like Coleman two burner stove there. Sealed container. Chunks cake. Jake and the Inu part 2. I took it. I didn't read it because I need to read part one. There is a part one. I'm assuming there's a part one. Alright. Some houses. I mean, apartments.
Off-worlders always ask how I can live here. I wonder how they can live anywhere else.
That's a very silly thing to say. Adrian Brasilia's diary. Things have been tough since Mom left and Dad died. I'm very alone here, but I'm hanging in there. Dad was never quite the same after she left, and Mom, Well, I'm glad she's gone. I never seemed good enough for her, and her new boyfriend was kind of a jerk. I'm finishing up school, and then hopefully I can get out of here too. But it's hard because even though my classes cost next to nothing, I still have lots of expenses and I barely have enough to eat. I only earn scraps from Jay and Anya. It's not like they have tons of credits either, and because I have to take time away from my studies, my grades suffer. It sucks. Why is everything so hard? How do other people do this? No one around here has really gone to college except for Dr. Lakota and maybe that new lady, Joyce. Dr. Lakota doesn't really have time for me, and the few times I went for advice, she was just like, stick with it, kid. You'll get there if you put in the work. I don't know what to do. I thought writing it down would help, but now I just have a place I can't... But now I just have a place I can't remember how bad I feel right now. So that's cool. That last sentence really doesn't make sense to me. One thing's for sure, these people do not have a lot of belongings.
Must be nice to be able to afford to travel, huh?
Oh, you're Adrian. Adrian! Alright, I'll talk to him.
Oh, you don't really want to talk to me. I'm just a nobody from the crates. Besides, I'm not really good at talking to tourists about New Homestead. If you're really interested in our history, talk to Maurice. He's a lot better at that than I am.
Is your head okay? That's what I was thinking. Yeah, please don't say that. I'm sure you're not a nobody.
I feel like it sometimes. I don't have many friends, and I'm struggling to stay in my undergrad program. It feels like I'm never going to get out of here and make a name for myself. Anyway, if we're going to talk, maybe we should talk about something else.
How do you feel about your home being a tourist destination?
It's not as bad as you'd think. I like talking to off-worlders, especially people my age. It gives me ideas for what I want to do when I'm done with school. Because, honestly, I'm not sure I want to stay here. It'll always be my home, but as soon as I can afford to, I'd love to explore my options.
What do you do here?
Well, I'm trying to finish up my undergrad schooling, actually. I want to be a physicist like my grandmother. Then, who knows what. But I also do some odd jobs here or there for money. Sometimes I help Jay out at his shop, and he gives me stuff in return. Sometimes I help Anya clean up at the Brown Horse when she's short-staffed. That sort of thing.
Okay. You mentioned something about the crates? What's that?
The crates are what we call the living quarters for the poor people. Like me. They're made from old shipping containers. We have to make do with the space we have here. They're comfortable enough, I guess. And no one on Titan is well off to begin with, but you can tell that people look down on us, especially some of the tourists.
Well, I'm only looking down at you because you're sitting on the floor. So you're having trouble with your studies?
Okay, well, no. Not the studies specifically.
Sorry about that.
Like, I get good grades when I'm able to apply myself. But I'm poor. I just don't have the kind of money to be a full-time student and support myself, even living in the cheap-ass crates. I keep having to take odd jobs just to put food on my plate, and when I do, my grades suffer. I just feel like I'll be stuck in a rut forever.
Why can't she go part-time? Sorry, I'm not giving her 20,000 credits. You can be successful without finishing school. You might just need to get out of New Homestead.
Really? I thought it was the only way. I remember my parents telling me that when they were still around. But maybe you're right. I guess I can put my studies on hold, at least until I get enough credits saved up to live on. I can always return to my studies then. Maybe part of the reason I feel I've been stuck in a rut is because I push myself too hard. Thanks for the advice. It helped.
I'm sure she appreciates the advice, but I think actual funds would have been a bit more helpful.
Are you standing there? Wait.
Okay.
Where? Where even is she talking to me? Are you talking to me through the wall? That's very... Oh, look. Space frog.
Is a backwoods world? Maybe it is, but that doesn't really bother me.
That's funny, though, because I bring up... You could leave this place, and then she's like, oh, thanks for the advice. I'll not leave this place, and I'll just save up first. I know some injured. Alright, let's take a look at the clinic, and then we'll continue on the tour. That's kind of awesome. I came from new... Did I hear a computer open up? I heard a computer open up.
If you take one of those stupid tours, make sure to follow the rules. They're for your own safety and my sanity.
I'm not interested in your sanity, sorry. Patient's clothes. Used for treating afflictions. Yeah, she can see me. She's looking right at me now. That one just has notebooks. I am interested in this boosted injector. But, well, she's interested in
what
me being interested in the boosted injector. Hi.
Do you need medical assistance? Stay safe.
Yeah, talk to her. Would you take? Look like you just stuffed a clipboard into your pants or something. I could read that.
I'll treat you if you need it. But please try to be more careful around me.
Well, she's the one taking your clipboards. At least I think she is. Oh. I don't know if I can get into this. That one's not working. Auto slot. Tough one. Maybe I can tackle it at another time. Child. We've got a Synapse Alpha. That's not working out for me. This is the bathroom? Oops.
Stay outside for too long here on Titan. You'll freeze solid without the proper protection.
Stop looking at me. I want this thing. All right, guy.
Have any questions so far?
How many people live here?
I'm not sure the exact count, but New Homestead is a fairly small colony. What you see is what you get for the most part, except for some other people who live in the private lower levels. Some, particularly security, and yours truly, even commute from other worlds.
Can you tell me more about how people lived before this was all built?
The original Titan Astrobase had more habitation pods on the surface connected to some of the old structures you may have seen in the back. As the colony grew, the base was expanded underground, and those hab units were recycled into materials used down here.
Okay. The overflow area looks cramped. What's up with that?
Sadly, it's difficult to get additional construction done inside these underground caverns. So for now, additional populations are housed in these stacks of old shipping crates. As you might expect, this is where some of the less wealthy can afford to live. It's not glamorous, but they are functional and cozy.
I'd like to check this out in more detail.
Oh, sure, I'll be here waiting. The locals love to talk with tourists, but they'll let you know if they're busy. So, please respect them.
Yeah, I already did that. That's a lounge. Yes, I've looked at all this stuff. Alright.
Have any questions so far?
I think I'm ready for whatever is next on the tour.
Alrighty! We'll be taking the residential elevator to the farms area on the surface level. This way, please! Let's leave these good people alone for now. Go check out the farms! Follow me up the elevator!
I wanted to see this first.
Off-worlders always ask how I can live here. I wonder how they can live anywhere else.
Lots of history here, if you're into that sort of thing.
I don't mind the tourists. They help the local economy.
Sweet one. Cool. I want her to come in. Letter to the school board. To whom it may concern, my daughter Sylvie is part of the UC Remote World Learning Program. In this month's study kit, she was assigned to a book titled The Hills Cry Jemison. As I do all books assigned to her, I took to reading it first to judge suitability for my daughter. How do you get off giving her this garbage to read? Her assigned learning counselor tells us it's really about building friendships, learning to tolerate others' differences, and overcoming adversity. That's all fine and good. Those are important lessons, but I see it for what it is, nothing but propaganda, promoting your planet. My daughter is a proud New Homesteader, and I see to it she remains that way. I don't want her getting silly ideas in her head about picking up from her home and family and moving to your consumer wasteland of a world. Sylvie will not be reading this book. Oh my god, what a control freak. I want my daughter to learn, but if you keep sending her material that pushes her away from me, I'll have no choice but to homeschool her, which places a huge burden on my family due to our forming responsibilities. Please reconsider the reading material you send our way. Nathaniel Manila. Oh, I don't like that guy. Not at all. Oops. My life, chunk by chunk. I was very young, only 7 years old, when I realized humans are animals. Smart animals, sure, but still animals. You give us food, we'll eat it. We want it to taste good, and we want it to stop our hunger. Those two things, that's what's most important. After that, sure, some people want their food to be really healthy, as the experts say, and some want it to be pretty. But most people, they just want to cram something into their face, and that's when the concept of chunks was born. So begins the 120-page autobiography of Fred Blombart, founder of the Chunks food franchise. I think I might have read that one already. Alright, well, I want some of this stuff. Canuck Maple Cola. I wish she would just come in or something. She's gonna open it again. 5 health. It's not really worth it. I took the other thing for the O2 consumption. Alright. I feel like talking to this guy again now. Fields of Everglass? Did I read that one? Oh yeah, I read this Talat. Oh, there's a person right there. We got an amp there. Got it. Danger. Pinch points. Stay clear of machine when in operation. Follow lockout procedures before servicing. Who's that supposed to be? Suite 1 and 2. Alright, let's go follow him then. Oh, hello there. Extreme cold?
We used to get more tourists
New
than
Homestead
we do these days.
Farms are the beating heart of the colony. Without them, the original outpost would shrivel and die. These pods are sealed and climate controlled. The urban environment for growing the hydroponic vegetation needed for survival in the early days of the colony.
I'm gonna talk to this guy again. I mean, I've already looked around this area.
Papa, you're always talking about how important it is to preserve our traditions. But why do we have to farm? How is that part of our tradition?
Well, we tend to farm here because we need to grow food. And that's what our ancestors did on Earth.
But didn't they have big open fields and giant machines? We don't have any of that.
She makes a good point, dear.
It's because we have a much smaller space to work with.
So then, it's not really the same, is it?
She had this conversation before.
How is it a tradition if it's not the same thing as
they used to the methane process and smell.
So then...
After a while...
Why is it important that we preserve
What are you doing?
I don't know. It just is. Now, we don't want to fall behind on work, so let's get back to it, okay, kiddo?
I want to talk to him again.
Okay, fine. Did you know...
I overheard you speaking to my wife, Mara. Filling her head with ideas about picking up and leaving home.
Yeah, again.
You got anything to say for yourself?
Sad, huh?
Yeah, we've had this conversation already.
Goodbye.
I wanted to talk to him about the letter to the school.
Any questions about the farms?
What do they grow here?
These days, it's a mix of what you find elsewhere in the galaxy, but in the olden days, it was all brought over from Earth. It was a lot of hardy root vegetables like potatoes, carrots, beets, and such, supplemented with corn, peas, green beans, soy, etc., which didn't always grow as well.
Hmm. Are the farms still operational?
Oh, they are indeed. Colonists still cultivate plant-based food for their own consumption here in New Homestead. It's less vital to their survival these days, as they also import supplemental food from other colonies, including meats, dairy, and synthetics. However, most citizens here take pride in a new homestead-grown, sustainable diet.
All right. How is this different than anywhere else in the galaxy?
Good question. It's largely the same, because this was the colony that pioneered the techniques you see elsewhere. But you'll notice that the farms here are smaller and staffed by humans, not robots. Things here are a little more old-fashioned compared to some of the large factory farms you'll find elsewhere in the settled systems.
Okay. I'm ready to move on with the tour then.
Onward it is! We'll be stopping by the Brown Horse Tavern later in the tour, which uses many of these locally sourced ingredients in their cooking. But for now, it's just a short way to our next stop. Follow me! So, the old bio labs are just on the other side of this building, believe it or not. We'll step on through the hallway there.